Today in the United States of America, your zip code is more important as a risk for a heart attack than your genetic code. In one neighborhood, 5 miles away from another neighborhood in any community in this country, your survival could be 15 years less just because you live there. And that's just not right.
Actively involved in working with households through interdisciplinary teams, physicians, nurses, social workers, to address not only health, but also the social determinants of health.
What we're trying to teach our students here is something very, very different. If 80% of diseases in this country are caused by non-biologic causes, why aren't we teaching those causes to our students so they can improve the health outcomes of our nations? Those are what we call social determinants, or the non-biologic causes, and they can be anything from lack of education, to lack of transportation, to lack of support services, to violence in a community, to prejudice.
Traditional medicine, it used to be based off a biological model, and so something here at FIU that we really try to focus on is a biopsychosocial model, which is involving not just medicine, but also social and psychological aspects of care, because it's a very holistic process.
We felt it very important that our students were introduced early into the community, into patient care, and the integration process throughout all 4 years of the medical school. It really provides a student with a unique opportunity to harness all that energy to do good for the community right away in the first year of medical school.
From day one, our students are seeing patients. And by month number 4 or 5, they've been assigned one of the poorest households in Dade County. And you know what? They're responsible for their care until they graduate. So this is not just learning how to take care of a heart attack. This is learning how to take care of somebody who has a risk for a heart attack, how to prevent it, and to see how it goes through the 4 years that they're in college.
Of course, you make your own decisions in the future. This is just something maybe you would want to be interested in.
I have 3 boys. I'm a mother of 3, and unfortunately, you tend to care for, you know, them first, and, you know, I tend to leave myself for last. I didn't have insurance, and, you know, to go to a doctor and, you know, the test and everything is too much money, unfortunately.
Most people don't have the money to solve those problems, and their service is really intuitive. They not only give the medical students training, but they also give the families who need the help the help.
The social determinants of health are very specific and can affect our ability to really help our patients. They have to be dressed together. Everything has to be considered. If it's a food desert and they have no access to fresh vegetables and fruit, they can't follow your instructions. If they're in an unsafe neighborhood and they can't walk to get there or have transportation to get to the pharmacy to fill the prescriptions, they can't fill the prescriptions. If they don't have money to fill the prescriptions, they can't follow your instructions. If there are no parks and no recreational facilities, how are they going to exercise on a regular basis?
We have 110 community partners. These partners then identify for us the families in greatest need. So it becomes the school teacher that calls us, the business owner, the faith-based organization.
It's a wonderful project. We became a partner, a community partner at Paradise Christian School, which is a Head Start program. We have 185 children that are Head Start, which are children that are below poverty level in their families. And these are families basically that need everything. FIU came and offered us interns to come and help us with our children, the medical care, and making different health plans and different things with the class, and also to do home visits with families with medical care and medical visits. So we became a great partnership with one another.
But the most amazing part was in the student group, we were able to decrease the usage of emergency rooms for primary care or just for visits for doctors from 61% to 26%, just by taking care of the social determinants. So if you look at it from a perspective, wow, this saved the family a whole night of sitting in the ER, they can actually go to work the next day, et cetera, et cetera. How much money did that save our society? And also, Johnny gets to make it to school and gets to get good grades. Johnny, you better get good grades, that's the deal.
For every dollar that the state gives us in terms of support for the college, we were returning $6 to the state. So there was an immediate return on investment.
Okay, did you do this with all these germs?
Imagine if we could take that money that we're spending on healthcare because we take care of folks and put it into education. Wouldn't that be a great idea? Because education within itself helps prevent disease.
I have no words to thank them. I have, you know, they're a blessing. They're a blessing. I don't know what else to say.
From the Herbert Wertheim College of Medicine, from the entire FIU community, the entire community of South Florida, we are honored, we are privileged to receive this award from the Florida Blue Foundation. I also want to thank the Florida Blue Foundation for your interest in making our state healthier, to make the individuals happier, and just in all to make us the best state in the country.